For the week of June 20th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15. Your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Boy Scouts, Cub Scouts, Venturers, members of the Veterans of Foreign Wars Organization and Fleet Reserve Association came together on Flag Day to honorably retire several American flags during a ceremony in Yokosuka. Kim McCann, the unit commissioner for scouting in Yokosuka, said the scouts do these ceremonies to ensure the flags are retired with pride.
Boy Scouts of America were enacted by Congress to be allowed to retire our flags when they become too old to be staying in service. We do this honorably with all the pride and integrity we can for what they deserve.
Eagle Scout Nathan White said the flag reminds him of what the U.S. stands for, even while living overseas.
I think it has a really deep meaning. Being an American and especially stationed overseas, the flag is very important to me and what it represents.
Nigel Shaw, another Eagle Scout, said it was great to share his experience with other members of the community.
Usually we have these with just the troop. I'm happy to have the community here to see what we do and to pass down all these values that we have for the flag into our community so they can understand that our flag is not just a symbol of our pride, it's a symbol of everything that the United States stands for.
Petty Officer Bryan Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
But in the United States Army, they are officers.
Army recruiters visited Fleet Activities Yokosuka to brief sailors on opportunities as Army warrant officers. The brief was designed to assist sailors who may be considering options to serve in other branches of the military, as CTT1 Bailey describes.
Basically, with the Navy's manpower shaping and things like that, you know, they're always, you know, who's going to be able to stay, who's not going to be able to stay. And I guess I'm just looking to see, you know, what kind of options the Army can offer me as far as, you know, programs to be able to transfer over to the Army if that was something I chose to do.
Army warrant officers serve as specialized experts and trainers in their career fields. And warrant officer candidates aren't always Army soldiers.
Well, because this program is available to all DoD service members, all right, it basically just gives those the sailors the ability to continue serving their nation, but in a different capacity. Now they're not going to be, maybe they're not in the Navy anymore, but they're in the Army. And they become a warrant officer. So that, I mean, that's the biggest thing, to continue to serve their nation.
For me, it was a childhood dream to be in the military, so it's something I really appreciate and have the opportunity to do.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan. Regardless, we're out here.
With summer here, many sailors and their families are getting outdoors and enjoying the weather. One of the most popular summer activities for service members is making the climb up Japan's famous Mount Fuji, a goal that may take a little preparation. Yokosuka's Director of Outdoor Recreation, Stephen Marksberry, says MWR often runs trips up the mountain, but participants need to do a safety brief beforehand.
We run one overnight a month, and then we run day trips every single Saturday, the first Saturday in July to the last Saturday in August. To sign up for any of those trips, you first have to go through a safety brief.
Participants are often concerned with the difficulty of the climb, and Marksberry says that although the distance of the hike might not seem like much, the altitude can be tough.
It's a round trip, around a 10-mile hike, which isn't that big a deal until you start going to the altitude. So you're starting about the essentially Denver, Colorado sort of height, and going up to 12,300 feet in the altitude.
Donna Carter, Yokosuka's fitness events coordinator, says that people thinking about making the climb should stay active to make sure they're prepared physically.
The hardest part is really going to be acclimating your body to the altitude changes. The fitter you are, obviously, the better off. If you just decide, I'm going to wake up today and go climb Mount Fuji, you're probably not going to get very far.
MWR Fitness has several programs that can help you prepare for the trip, including a Fuji Indoor Climbing Challenge. Petty Officer Bryan Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.